As you probably know, Elon Musk's company SpaceX is currently working on developing Starship, the rocket which will one day take humanity to Mars. The whole Starship rocket is an impressive construction, but an even more interesting thing is the interior of the rocket. Inside Starship, there is a large payload fairing which is 9 meters in diameter and 18 meters high. Ultimately, this storage will be used as the living space for 100 astronauts during various space travels. Due to the problems like zero gravity conditions and the length of space travels, SpaceX will have to design this area in a way which provide the crew with adequate living conditions and ensure safety. How the Starship interior will look like? And how will look like daily life inside the rocket during space travels? About this and much more in today's video. The Starship system is made of two parts. The Starship spacecraft is stuck on a rocket booster called Super Heavy. The Starship spacecraft itself is 50 meters high, but the whole rocket system is 120 meters high. In addition, the Starship is 9 meters in diameter, which makes it even more massive. So, what exactly is inside this giant construction? Basically, the Starship can be divided into two main parts. In the lower part, there are fuel tanks and engines, and on the top, there is a payload section. Starting at the bottom part of the rocket, there are 6 Raptor engines, which will be the main propulsion system of the Starship. Above those engines, there are propellant tanks, or more precisely, liquid oxygen tank and liquid methane tank. The two giant propellant tanks are separated by a common dome, and together these tanks are meant to contain 1,200 tons of fuel. At the front of the spacecraft is a huge payload compartment that will be used to haul large cargo or people to a destination in deep space. This is the part that is relevant to us today. So let's take a closer look at the Starship payload section. Starship can carry up to 100 people and is meant to hold a payload of up to 150 metric tons. This is really a huge amount of space to use. Let's just compare it with the Starlink mission's example. Falcon 9, which is currently launching the Starlink satellites into orbit, is able to carry up to 60 satellites, whereas the Starship will be able to transport as many as 400 Starlink satellites. It makes a significant difference, especially when we consider the fact that the cost per launch for Falcon 9 is around $50 million, while for a Starship, it's only $2 million. However, as we know, Starship will not only be used for cargo transportation. In the future, the Starship will also be used for things like launching astronauts to the International Space Station, crewed moon missions, or even transporting people to Mars. Of course, it is possible to design the space of the payload bay depending on the purpose of the mission. For such big projects as the Mars mission, you need to provide the crew with adequate living conditions, especially considering the fact that the mission will last about 7 months and up to 100 people will travel aboard spacecraft. Each astronaut will probably have their own special sleeping cabin, with 2 to 3 cabins in a room. These cabins will probably resemble something we have seen in those Japanese capsule hotels. Now, they may not be too big, but we must remember that they are only to be used for sleep. Other than that, the crew will spend most of their time in other rooms, such as the passenger area or common room. The first flight to Mars is expected to take around 7 months. Now, this may sound like nothing compared to the time spans we have known earlier, but it is still a lot, especially for the crew. Astronauts who spend this much time in zero gravity, conditions start to develop, problems with their bones, muscles, and cardiovascular systems. So, to remedy that, we can expect an exercise room with specialized equipment, where the passengers will have to work out to keep up their health. The same zero-gravity conditions also require a special toilet, similar to the one present at the International Space Station. You can also expect a specialized kitchen space, but don't expect to be served 5-star meals. The food up there will be quite different from the one on Earth. Meals will consist of thermostabilized foods like cans of tuna, that have been processed to destroy deleterious microorganisms and enzymes. But food and toilet facilities aren't the only things that humans need to survive. The spacecraft will need to be equipped with a proper life support system, which includes the air we breathe in. So, a life support system will involve filtering out the appropriate amounts of carbon dioxide while retaining the optimum levels of oxygen. There is also the matter of drinking water. The International Space Station makes use of what is called a regenerative life support system. This is a contained system that recycles things in a closed loop to maintain the longevity of human activity. The urine and sweat are all recycled into drinking water. Some of this water is split into oxygen using a process called electrolysis to maintain the atmosphere. Musk has said that the Starship will feature a similar regenerative system, but this will take up a lot of space and will add excessive weight onto the rocket. Moreover, SpaceX has not demonstrated any experience with developing a regenerative life support system. The company did launch the Dragon spacecraft into orbit, but even that ship had a carefully pre-supplied system with a limited lifespan. Another room that, of course, will have to be on the Starship board is a hold space with all cargo that will be needed during the mission and directly to Mars, such as Mars rover vehicles. The Starship is also expected to have shielded rooms or areas that will be designed to protect the passengers from solar radiation. This is another critical unknown, as previous space and moon missions did not have to factor in the scenario. It will definitely be a scene when 100 people are rushing to specific rooms every now and then. In addition to special shielding, one side of the Starship could feature a viewing gallery of sorts, where the passengers would be able to view the galaxy and ultimately the red planet as the ship approaches Mars. Beyond the living quarters, SpaceX has been looking into offering entertainment in the common areas, which would be needed in the 7-month-long journey to Mars. There was even an idea that Musk might hold zero-gravity concerts. Now, won't that be an amazing experience? Musk says that he hopes to achieve a construction rate of 100 starships per year, as he set a goal of moving 1 million people to the red planet by 2050. The goal is to make it common enough and affordable enough that anyone can go if they want. SpaceX even plans to make loan plans available for those who don't have the money. Each starship is expected to have a useful target life of around 20 to 30 years. This is a necessary requirement if the company wants to make these flights viable. At this point, all these starship interior concepts may seem unrealistic, but there is actually a high chance that we will see the first people living inside Starship in just a few years. Maybe it won't happen during the journey to Mars, but during the first Artemis moon mission. As you probably know, NASA revealed that it has chosen SpaceX's Starship as the lander that will bring two Americans to the moon's surface in 2024. Basically, it means that NASA, in collaboration with SpaceX, will put humans on the moon for the first time in over 50 years. In addition, thanks to this contract, Elon Musk's company will have the opportunity to test most of these life-supporting systems, which I've described, even before the Mars mission. If you are interested in more content related to Starship, I invite you to watch my previous video in which I talk about the nuclear-powered Starship concept and how it could reduce the time of space travels.